The digital signature is a reality of many applications. Then we have to inside our software to validate if a certain file has a valid signature or not. One typical way for validating signatures and for storing signatures of files is using the p7s files. So these files contain the information about one signed file. In this example, this file A is the original file and the signature of this file is stored here in this p7s. And the same for file B. Here is the file B and here is the signature file for the file B, the p7s file. So we have two files that are signed. Okay, so we know that this PDF file is just normal files and the p7s is the file that contain the signature information. Here, if you try to open the signature file, we know the people that has signed this file, we know the algorithm and a lot of another information about this file. Okay, but now how to build a software that can receive one original file and one p7s file and say if it's valid or not. So we are going to see that now. Here we have one Java application and we have as a dependence, we have in the pom.xml file from Maven, we import this dependence, the demoiselle library. It's documented here inside the cert code that's available to be downloaded in the link description of this video. So once you have downloaded the dependence, you can import that here in our code and you see how simple it is to validate that. What we have in this code? Here is how we are going to test that. First, we give the original file and its respective signature file, the p7s, and then we verify if the content and if the signature are valid. If yes, it say it's valid. If not, it will say it's not valid. Okay, simple. So we have the another case that we have the original file and the signature of the inverse file, another file. So it's not matched and it will be invalid. Okay. Okay. What functions do we have here? Basically, one read content function that's very simple, that basically transforms this path in a byte array with the content of the file. So it has here the PDF and the P7S and it will return to us the byte array of the file. Okay, nothing new until here. But now let's take a look about this function. Here is the core of this video, how to validate the signatures. We're going to see that now. Basically, we have to create one object for this card checker class. And this object has one method, checkData, of detached signature. Why detached? Because some p7s files contains inside the p7s file the copy of the original file it has signed. But it's not the case here. It's detached. The original file is here and the p7s is here separated. So it's detached. So that's why we use this method. And we pass here the content and the signature. If it's not valid, we already have one exception triggered. And then we know it's false. The signature is not valid. However, if it does not trigger an exception, it's because it's valid. And then we know it's valid. And then we can read a lot of information about this signature. Basically, our information we can read here, if you double click the file, our information that's here available, we can also read by our program with this API. So we know what time and date the document was signed, who was the person that has signed the document, what's the hash algorithm that was generated for the signature, and so on. So now let's execute this example and see one example of files being validated when it's identified the signature is valid, and another example of file being not validated because the signature file do not match the original file. Okay, running that. Just wait, and we are going to see in the output the result of this running code. Okay, here's the valid example. And then once it's valid, we can here take the information we have, the information we had in this point extracted, the data, the hash, the name of person that has signed that. We have printed that here. Here's the date it was signed. Here is the hash generated. Of course, the hash is a binary content, so it's not exactly to be printed in the screen. And here the name of who has signed the file. Okay, and then here is the invalid example where we try to validate with files that does not match. Right, so this code is available to be downloaded by you. You can see it's just one single file that has the main method. So everything you need to run this example is here, with the exception of the files that were presented in this example. But with any p7s file and the original file, you will be able to run this example. Thank you for watching.